Okay, and let me just give me 1 second to check on the girl, because they're going to go to trivia night tonight, and I got to see if she wants to go. Going to trivia night. It's great. Now let's see. So what have we got here? I want to look at something really easy that we can work on this technique. Did some slow airs, I'm sure. Oh, let's see. We could do a Black Velvet Band. With the jiggle. Oh, we did a Shogun. That's good. I'm glad we did that. We got a lot of tunes here that we did. Okay, let's do that. Let's do the Skyboat Song. That's what we can do. That would be perfect to do with the jiggle. So, Skyboat Song. You guys remember that? It's a blast from the past. To do this with. So, well, first of all, it's been a while, so we better refamiliarize ourselves with the tune altogether, because it might be a little unfamiliar for a couple of you. Okay. So, first of all, let's just play it, shall we? Just straight up play Skyboat Song, the theme music to Outlander, I think. Okay, here we go. I better mute everybody. I don't know if I did. Yeah, you're all muted. That's great. All right.
Thank you.
still in there? Is it still under the fingers? Okay, good. Just want to give you 1 second while I tell Sylvia what's going on. Okay, so now it's in there, and that's good, but let's practice it a good couple of times. Let's play it 2 times, okay? Make sure it's there, and then we'll try it with a jiggle. So play it straight up 2 times, yeah.
What note are you ending on?
G.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, it's a, we'll resolve it.
Yeah, okay. It's on a D here, so that's...
Yeah, it's because it's the middle part, right?
Yeah.
So it's like, because it's a song, so it's verse chorus.
Right. Okay.
Okay. All right, let's do it. Are ready to go. Sky. Okay, how did that go? It's good? Right on. Now let's see about jiggling. See how that's gonna work there? We're gonna jiggle our way through it. And when you're jiggling the bow, although you're gonna have the impulse to and try to tighten this here, you're going to try to be let it loose. Just let it loose. And it might be a bit messy with the sound. It might be have a few little chirps and pops and crunches, but don't worry about it. We're going for an overall feeling of looseness with the right hand, and that's why we're doing it, okay? So let's play it jiggled as best we can, right through from one end to the other. And yes, that's good, Debbie. Just relax that hand. That's the way to do it, man. Okay, let's do it. Ready to go. Faces were hilarious. My God, how entertaining that was. So tell me how you got along. How about you, Astrid? Have you ever tried to do that before? I don't know if you were around for any of the jiggling.
No, I haven't been around, and I think right after the B part, I'm not going to make this.
We started to tighten up?
Yeah, I did. And then you said, okay, you got to lighten up, or, don't get tightened up there. So yeah. I thought about it, and then I proceeded on working on a little bit better. So,
Good. Yeah, it's a really good thing to do. It's just in a general way to get this kind of thing, this motion happening that's so important for fennel.
Yeah.
Yeah. How about you, Debbie? How'd you do the fit? Your faces were the best. And I'm sure there was some, it looked like there was a few curses in there too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It started to go right down into the elbow. I was like, okay, don't do the elbow. And then it started trampoline instead. It's like, don't.
Okay, so you were able to remind yourself a few times, and that's exactly what happens with this exercise. So that's fine. And the faces were entertaining, so no problem at all. How about you, Elaine? How did you do?
Let's say it wasn't my finest moment.
Okay. Just getting stiff or not working at all?
Yeah. It's like you can't walk and chew gum at the same time kind of thing.
Okay. Well, why don't we have a couple of more cracks at it? Now, the way that we did it up in Wiki was we would play regular Amazing Grace and then jiggled and then back to regular to give you a break. So why don't we try doing that? Okay, we'll try two times. Three. We'll have a crack at it jiggled, then we'll do it non-jiggled for a break, and you can think about all the things that you're going to try to do better the next time when we jiggle, and then we're going to do jiggle again, okay? So three times total. A little drink of water to get me through. Okay. Okay. Jiggly, jiggly, ready to go. Thank you. Okay, regular. Look much more ease. How do you feel? Jiggly?
Yeah, that was better.
That's good. That's good. Okay, now let me just check on the girl here. Just one sec. Okay, she's gone to trivia night, which is just great. I'm not a big fan of trivia, although I'm really good at it. I don't, you know, those kind of nights that get boring for me, but I usually kill. I read a lot of useless information. I was going down a rabbit hole today of the bow on the strings, because I was looking on Facebook and somebody had posted these pictures of everything under a microscope. It was really, really cool. Like, all just different things under a microscope. And then I remembered looking at the pictures of bow hair under a microscope, which is great. And I really, really enjoyed that. And I was looking for it. I couldn't find those pictures anywhere. But what I did find was a really cool slow motion video of a bow on a G-string. And the G-string is purposefully loosened a little bit so that you can really see the sway of the string. Well, I can show you guys, I guess. I don't have to describe it. Okay, one second here. Bow on the string. Violin. Oh, this thing. Where is it? Is this it? No, that's not it.
My dog was responding to the kitty meows, and I said, "What's she doing?" And it's the cat.
Yeah, it's the cat. I think she wants to go out. Let's see, because she just ate. Come on now. I just saw this video like 5 seconds ago. Oh, here we go. It's one of them anyway. Oh, come on. Hey, Dad. That's the cat. Okay. Oh, here it is. All right. So let me share the screen. Okay. And so you see how the strings move. See that? Kind of slaps back and forth like that. And there's actually a corner. You can kind of see it on this, right here on the A string, but do you see how there's a corner that comes around, like kind of goes, travels up and down the string? Let's see if the other one is here. It's much better. Here it is here. Okay. Takes a minute to get going. Then it really starts going. You see it starting there now? It's just starting to kind of go a little bit. It's very slow motion. I'll put it up to here. There you go. You see you're going now? Isn't that neat? And you can really see the corner that moves around the string. It goes, there it goes. It goes and it comes back and it goes down and it comes back. See that? That's the corner that the guy discovered in the late 1800s using stop motion photography. And they figured out that this is the way the string moves. Now, I love visualizing this motion when I'm playing because it helps me to get out of the way of the vibrating string. I picture it in my mind and I try to go with it instead of against it. And I find that it really helps. But isn't that something? Now, in the middle of the video, it really gets going. There, now, that's where it's really going. You see that? You can really see that corner moving up and down the string. And my goal, especially with the G string all the time and the E string, is to not get in the way of that corner. To let it pass by the bow, unaffected. Anyway, that's what I do in my spare time. I look at videos like that and try to figure out what the hell exactly what's going on with the bow, you know what I mean? Anyway, that's enough of that. So now let's try our set of jigs now that we've jiggled so much. It's going to be awesome. And that's the Irish Washerwoman. No, is it? Yeah. Irish Washerwoman. And the Swallowtail and the other one. Sets. Morrison's in the Swallowtail. That's right. Okay, so let's give that a go. Irish Washerwoman, Morrison's Jig, and the Swallowtail. 2 times each with a very nice loose right hand. And let's see. Somewhere around there with the tempo, I think it'd be good. Okay. Oh, there's Lena. She's late, but she's here. Better late than never. Hi, Lena.
Hello, I'll be with you in a moment.
No problem. We're just about to start with that set we were practicing last time. We just did a whole bunch of bowing work, so we're going to use that bowing work on the set here.
Nice.
Okay. A 1, 2, 3, go, 2, 3. Morrison's. See, how long was that set? 7 minutes. That's a long stint of playing. How's everybody's wrists? Is it okay? Did it work out okay? That's great. I made the mistake there going into the Swallowtail. For some reason, I almost went into Morrison's again. So that was me. If you were wondering what was going on there, that was me. Okay? But otherwise, I thought everybody looked like they were smoothly just moving along there, besides that little hiccup. So keep working on it, okay? We'll try it faster next time, a little bit faster. Now, for your reference, that was on the metronome. Yeah, 60. 60 pretty well bang on the money on the metronome. Okay, so that's what we did tonight. And it looked, like I said, it looked like it was successful. So I'd say that practicing at 60 is going to be highly successful. And next time we'll try it a little bit quicker. Okay, now let's see. So we had some other sets. I'd like to change the time signature. Where are these? Okay, so we got, oh, Hector, Rowan Tree, Hawk Hay, Johnny Ladd, and the High Road to Linton. That's a good one. That's a blast from the past. We have Devil's Dream and Mrs. McLeod's. Let's practice that. I just finished practicing Mrs. McLeod's with Liam, who is 12 or 11. He's 11. And he's trying to get us, having trouble with the second part. So his mom said he just played the first part over and over and over ad nauseum all week. She doesn't mind though, she plays the flute. And her father is a piper, Bob. Illan Piper. Okay. So we're gonna do, yeah, and then the Devil's Dream. Let me get that up here. Yeah. Okay. Now I don't know how fast we had it last time. Would this work? Think that'd work for a tempo? Let's give it a try and see, shall we? I better go let that cat out. You guys get familiar with that Devil Among the Tailor while I go let the cat out. Just be a minute. She's freaking. All right, she's happy now. Okay, so two times each, I would say, is good. And we talked about the tempo already. So let's have a go at them. Okay. Here we go, two times each. One, two, three, go. Repeat. All right. How did we do with that set? Oh, there's Lena. How you doing, Lena? Hey, nice couch. Okay, how did we do with the set? We'll start with you, Debbie. Well, oh, I saw you stopped there halfway through. Maybe I wasn't clear about what tune we were going into.
The next one was we were leading into it. Both of them were really rusty. So I was like, yeah. After the first go through, it was like, oh, yeah, that's sweet, actually.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
But how about the stamina? You were able to get through both of them, no problem?
Not cleanly and not pleasantly for anybody nearby. Yeah.
Is it scratchy or is it touching other strings or what?
No, just my speed wasn't staying consistent. It was like da 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 da, like, you know.
Oh. Yeah. I'll tell you, I remember my mom used to get after us all the time for that when we were practicing. Stop rushing through the easy parts. The way you can do it on the fiddle, though, is so, that's so nice about the fiddle, is that you can do it with your length of bow. So try to use consistent length of bow, right, you know, through the whole tune. So, you know, your quarter note, your half note. If you can do that in a relative way, like, you know, it'll steady up your tempo. That's what I do. So I find when I'm starting to feel like I want to race, you know what I mean? I lengthen that bow and I make sure every quarter note gets that whole thing. You know what I mean? And then it'll be more consistent. But that's the nice thing about violin, because when you're playing the piano, you just poke and wait, so you can rush through those things really, really easy, right? But with the fiddle, all you got to do is just make sure you're covering that real estate every time, and you should keep on an even keel just as a result of that. Do you see what I mean? Yeah. Okay, good. How about you, Elaine? How did you do with the two tunes? Probably not bad, eh?
No, it was met, except I think I had a different version of the Devil's Dream, a more complicated one. So
yeah, this one is very simple. I do prefer the more complicated one, but apparently this simple one is kind of like the actual tune when I was looking for it.
Okay.
Isn't that interesting? I found that very interesting. I really like the more complicated version better, but it still gives you the good. A good foundation with it. How about you there, Astrid? How did you do?
Well, I it was a little fast, but I'm having trouble with the fingering on the third bar of the Devil's Dream, and I'm finding it difficult to put the three fingers down and then back to one and then one finger.
Oh, put your one on both strings.
Put my one on both. What does that mean?
On the A and the E. Watch this. See that?
Huh? Wow.
I do that all the time. If there's two notes like that on either string, I just plunk that one down on both and I leave it there.
But it's a D, F, B, F. Wait a minute. It's a D, so I have to have three fingers down.
Yep, have three fingers down, but have the one on both strings.
Oh.
And then it's just one move, really easy.
Oh, what a trick.
Okay. Get used to it, because this happens a lot, that move.
Okay. All right. That's great.
Yeah, okay. Good. Okay. And we'll practice that again. So that'll
yeah, thanks.
Yeah. How about you, Leah? How did you do?
Pretty good. I still think that the not string crossing sections are harder for me. Because I'm using that trick, like for the string crossing with the more fingers down,
yeah,
those parts seem fine. And then when I get to the like the last section of each part,
yes,
I have to like slow down to crunch through those, like
this here. Yeah, yeah.
I the most difficult part of that tune.
Oh, interesting. Well, you know, it's more complicated than the other parts of the tune, for sure. So why don't you play that ending for me? Play it twice, just that ending from the A3. Good, do it again. One more to be sure. Now that looks really smooth with good bowing. That should be better now when we get to it.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
Okay, let's do it again, guys. Same exact thing, except far better this time. Just, it's going to be night and day. Although I'm sure it wasn't that bad. So it's going to be like, you know, day and dusk. Okay, here we go. Same speed. One, two, three. Wow. That was fun. You know, I like playing tunes slow. I have no problem playing tunes slow. I get into it and I try different things. And I was trying all kinds of crap there. Anyway, how did you guys get along? Better with your little problems you were describing earlier?
Something magical just happened.
Oh.
My eyes didn't look at the music for a second and I got a little lost. And then when that part came along that I was just struggling with, my fingers just did it.
Ah, gotta love muscle memory.
And then I was so flustered that I lost the plot for the second part.
So too busy patting yourself on the back.
Oh my gosh. Can't believe this is happening.
Awesome. Okay, good. So let's pick another set now. Let's see. Okay. The polkas. Did we do the polkas? Last time? No, I don't think so. We should do the polkas. Because with those polkas, we have a chance of getting kind of fast, which would be really, really cool. So the polkas are the Carey polka and John Ryan's polka. Okay? The Carey is one of the first ones we learned, and John Ryan's is the one from the Titanic where they're all in the down in the steerage and having a great time where the rich people are upstairs being miserable. Now I'll just remind you guys what they sound like. It's been a while. Cheerful music. So we won't go that fast. We'll go kind of like this. See if we can handle that. Alrighty. Okay, and we'll do them two times each. It's plenty. A little drink of water. And we'll do it. Here we go. A one, two, three, go. Titanic music. You know, I saw Mythbusters recently where they tried out, you know, the end of the Titanic when she's on the board. There's not enough room for the two of them on the board, you know, when they're floating around the water. So he hangs off of the board and he dies and she lives. And when I remember when we watched that movie in my house, my dad turned to me and he said, "How come she won't give him a turn on the board?" Anyway, I was it happened. This Mythbusters came on, and what they were doing was there room for both of them on the board? And so they used a swimming pool or whatever, and so what it turned out was they could both be on the board, but the board would be swamped and they'd be in the cold water type of thing. You know what I mean? So I guess there wasn't room for both of them on the board, but it doesn't really explain why she didn't give him a turn. She could have gave him a turn. You know what I mean? Anyway, not very nice. How did we get along with the polkas? Was it good? It's good. How about you, Lena? You look like you have something to say.
The carry is good.
Yes.
John Ryan's is a struggle.
What happens?
Well, I know we've tried it faster and I can't do it any faster. Like that speed right there was actually pushing it in terms of speed. Like I can do it, but slower.
Yeah. I wonder what gets in the way when you're going fast. Is it just the quick notes? Like,
yeah, I think it's the quick notes. Yeah.
Okay.
And every time there's a da-da-da-da, yeah, it's like.
So, okay, you weren't here for the jiggle. We practiced the jiggle before we started all this here. And that's what you want to do when you hit that spot. You just go, chicka-ticka, see that? Instead of, okay, that's going to be the key for being able to do that. Anybody else have any trouble with anything? No? Okay, let's try it again. Now, we're going to go a bit quicker there, Lena. Tiny bit quicker, but you're going to try to use that loose wrist to do it, okay? Okay, so a little tiny bit quicker. So kind of like. All right, that's a good, cheerful, happy clip, but it's not fast for a polka anyway. Okay, here we go. One, two, three, and. Well, that looked like it went okay. Alina, it was better, right? Yeah, and I saw you definitely relaxing a little bit more, and that's definitely the way to get through it. Okay, it's if you just think of it as dum dee yappa dee da 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 instead of dum dum da 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 da. You know what I mean? It'll make it much better. Okay, how about everybody else? Is it okay? Yeah. Okay. Practice them because I want to get them faster because we can. We will be able to do it. So we definitely practice these and we'll keep working on them. Now let's pick something else. It's great to have such a great repertoire here. So many sets of tunes. Oh yeah, John Allen's Jig and Cock of the North. How about that? We'll go slow. We don't have to go fast. Why would we go fast? I'm not in any hurry. Nobody's trying to dance right now. So we should be able to go slow. I had to sub out of a gig. I double booked myself on the weekend. I told the guy I would play with him at McVeigh's Irish Pub downtown, but I have to do a dance. And I just told him, like, you're going to have to get somebody else to play at the pub because only a few people can play a dance. Like, it's not just playing tunes in the corner. You know what I mean? You have to know what you're doing. And in terms of knowing what you're doing, like, I don't know the dances or anything. I have no idea. I don't even pay attention to what they're doing on the floor. The only thing I pay attention to on the floor is when they swing, because that tells me the tempo that I need to play for them. Because when you swing with somebody, it's, you can't help it. The tempo is going to happen and it's going to be comfortable. And that's the tempo you need for them. Because if it's too fast, they're going to work too hard. If it's too slow, they're going to work even harder. So I do watch for the swing, but I don't know the dances or anything. It's the feel and the drive that you need to know how to do. If you don't know how to put that feel and that drive out there, it's going to be a boring dance. So anyway, he got somebody else to play the pub, and I'm going to do the dance, which I don't mind at all, because the dance is finished at 10. The pub's not done till 1 in the morning, and we're doing the Terry Fox run on Sunday morning. So dance is much more preferable. Okay, let's try it. John Allen's Jig. I don't remember how fast we got these, but it's been a while, so we should take it easy. We should go about here. That's gonna work? Okay, let's do it. Helmets on. 1, 2, 3, go. we do with the jigs? A major Scottish jigs. Is it okay? Yeah? No, that's good. Okay. Take a little breather. We're going to do it again. Tiny little bit brighter.
Small question.
Yeah.
When you transfer from one tune into the next one, do you play the pickup notes at the beginning of the second tune?
I think so. I think I did. So, yeah, you should, because it's a very straightforward way to get into the next tune. It's because you kind of go dumpy day, so da da dee da da dee da 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 da. See that? It would be very intuitive and easy on the hand. Good question, Lena. Any other questions before we try her? A little tiny bit. As my who is it now? This Irish fiddle player that I was working with down in New York, Brian Conway, great guy, and he was like. I was playing my Michael Coleman for him, and he was like, well, it's good. I would just take a little bit more time with it. Meaning, don't play it as fast. Anyway, let's give it a go. Okay. John Allen's. So more like this. Just a tiny little hustle. One, two, three, and. One more. looked like it went pretty well. So that's what you're going to practice. To around that speed would be fine, I'd say. But then I'd want to try it again next week a little faster. It would be really, really good. And then the other thing is, so we'll do one more week of these sets of jigs and reels to see if we can get those few sets a little bit faster and stronger. And then after that, I want to get back to slow airs because I see that you guys don't have many. We have Rosebud. We have a Shogun. We have Hector the Hero. But we need a few more. And it would really, I think, help with the bowing in general. Slow airs are really good for your bowing because it's very unforgiving. You know, you're there all on your own and you're playing this long note and it's like, you know, and so it gives you an opportunity to listen to your sound and to make any changes you want to make or bring anything out or do anything. So we'll get into that. We'll practice the airs that we have. So take a look at the Google Drive and get familiar, refamiliarize yourself with all the slow airs that we did. And we'll learn a couple more as well. Okay. But, and then remember the jiggle. That's the big thing. Next week, I want to do these sets again. So if you can remember the jiggle and the hand, arm when you're practicing this week, trying to get the hand doing some of the bowing to get us through these long sets. Okay. So that's your mission this week. And next week we'll do the sets again. I think I've worked you hard enough tonight. You all look like you're sweating. Okay. So we'll see you next Thursday, everybody. Bye-bye.